to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. With the first qualifying session of the season about to start, we should find out the performance level of the new cars and who might be contenders for this year's championship. But with rain falling, it's going to mix up the field.
We expect the Mercedes power unit to be strong this season, but with today's weather, we may not get a true indication of which team came out strongest from pre-season testing.
Hey guys, how's it going? Nolan's here, and welcome to the very first video of the F1 2015 career mode on the channel. Could you describe it career mode? Probably yes, although it's not described as that anymore in the game itself. I think it's something like a championship season or whatever. What I did, I went with Sauber, as you can see, not with Ericsson, who just overtook us and we almost hit him off track, but with Felipe Nasr. Why Sauber? I don't know. I really don't know. It's just a team a little bit at the back, and I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I was doubting between Sauber or McLaren Honda. I don't know whether McLaren Honda is actually quicker than Sauber. Probably it has more grip, but obviously the straight line speed is bad. So I don't know, and I don't care anyway. We are going to focus though on this qualifying session here in our Sauber. And then also, the new game. You know, this is the first F1 2015 gameplay on my channel. So we are going to start the game right now. So I can obviously imagine that people have a few questions about what I think about the game. I'm going to try to keep it short as we are on a queue lap at the moment. I like it. I think it is. It's decent. It's definitely a step up from where it has ever been. David Greco was actually the man who did the handling and then stuff, was part of the handling team, and I know him a little bit. I barely talk to him or anything like that, so don't think we are friends, because we are far from that. But I know him from FSR a bit, and I think he's done a really good job. I mean, the handling on this game is, I think, at the moment, in the perfect balance. That's the biggest compliment I can give the game, because as codemasters, you don't want to create a full simulator, because not everyone will play it, and you do want your game to sell quite well. But at the same time, you don't want it too arcade-ish, you know, for the people who are looking for a bit of a sim like me. I think they found the perfect balance. I mean, it is very nice the way it drives for both sim drivers. Who are used to driving simulators, and people who are used to drive more arcade-ish racing games, you know. I think they have found a really nice balance, probably the perfect balance, in fact. So that is the biggest compliment I can give. At the same time, there are a few issues with the game. Anyway, I think I explained it within the lap, and I think that is good enough. We set a 37.9 here on this qualifying lap, but we have another run in the back left. It's obviously very heavy rain, as you can see. I'm going to talk a little bit, obviously, about the session, because that's a bit more important than my ideas on the game. Or ideas, that's the right pronunciation, I think. Maybe I will do a Q&A on the channel in a week time or so, because I haven't done one in quite a long while. And maybe you can ask your questions then about the game, because this career mode, I don't want to talk all time about what I think, you know. I'm just going to focus on commentating over the gameplay, as we had a little of an oversteer moment there. This was one of the first races I did actually with the AI. I did a bit of time trail, scratched against the wall there. I did a bit of time trail before jumping into this, but I did not have a lot of practice at all. I did have some issues with my pedals though. It seems like the game was not really recognizing my fanatic pedals. It was recognizing it, but there was a big dead zone on the throttle, and the braking just didn't feel good at all. I tweaked that a little bit. The throttle dead zone is gone completely. The braking is better, but it still doesn't feel right. So I am not really comfortable with the brakes, which probably cost me a bit of time here and there. But I have already recorded the first three races. This is obviously the first race, and I can tell you that, you know, there is no solution for me to really make the brakes feel right. Anyway, 136.8, a really good lap there towards the end of the session. 9/10 of all in my little Sauber, so not too bad at all for the first qualifying session. of the career mode, and after only this was my first game or first day on the game, I think. So
it's been a not too bad qualifying performance from Mercedes today, with both cars on the front row for the race tomorrow.
It's been a great session for the team. They've really been pushing hard to make this happen, and their hard work has been rewarded.
Our teammate here in 18th place with a 1:38.
It's
quite a way off.
5 o'clock here local time, and welcome to race day here in Melbourne, Australia. The cars are on the grid, and they should be setting off shortly for the formation lap. It's a great position for Lewis Hamilton to start the season from, and one that he'll be hoping he can capitalise on and turn into a race win today.
Well, we all know that Lewis has raw speed, and if you give him a fast car, he'll win races. So if he can stay out front by the end of the first few corners, I'm sure he's going to be very difficult to beat.
How does Nico Rosberg go about finding the time he was lacking at the end of qualifying in today's race?
Well, he's got to stay within touching distance of the lead during the first stint, and then look to capitalise as the car becomes lighter and the tyre degradation eases.
Right, looking at the starting grid here, obviously Mercedes 1-2, then it's Ferrari. I think we will see that pretty much for the entire career mode, otherwise, or well, maybe there are some surprises here and there, but I don't see anything else happening, excuse me. Then the strategy here, obviously, is heavy rain yet again, so we are going to start on another set of full wet tires, and the first race of the season is underway right now. Lights went out with a reasonable start, keeping it in fifth place at the moment, but Bottas is alongside us. Actually take us on the inside, but I'm not going to give up that easily. Going around the outside, bit of contact, mate. Definitely nothing too serious. Using quite a bit of time there to the top four in the traction zone. So after qualifying, it does look like we are pretty much like best of the rest. It's at the front, it's just going to be Ferrari and Mercedes, especially Mercedes, of course. But I'll try what I'll try my best and see what I can do to mix myself up there. At the moment, it's not looking too shabby. A second of Raikkonen after that, after the first turn where I lost some time. So I need to look in my mirrors and pay attention to Bottas. So the car down nicely for this corner. What I wanted to say as well is, you guys might be surprised, I am not using T-Cat. You may notice, subscribers who have been here for quite a long while, so we skip already to the end of lap 7. Nothing happened, by the way. I'm just lapping really consistent. The all-time low 38s, high 37s. Very consistent, but I can't catch up to the guys ahead. Anyway, subscribers who have been here for quite a long while and have been watching some F1 2013, 14, 12 videos on the channel know that I was usually the guy who was really hardcore. I was also always driving cockpit mode and really paying attention to the track limits, but first of all, the cockpit mode, it doesn't work for me. Since I have the triple monitor set up, I can only really drive cockpit mode with all three monitors enabled. And for this game, if I want to do career mode, I have to record it in a single screen, otherwise you guys won't have the full effect, you know. You will see a completely different resolution, and it's going to be really tiny for you guys on YouTube watching the video. So I have to do it with one screen, and it doesn't feel natural for me at all anymore to actually drive cockpit with one screen. So there is that one. And secondly, track limits. I will try really hard to pay attention as much as I can, but at the same time, I'm not going to be like what I was previously, where I would really bash on myself when I made one slight extension or anything like that. Of course, I'm not going to cut corners deliberately, definitely not. I'll try to keep it clean as much as I can, but if I sometimes go a bit over the limit here and there, I'm not going to cry about it as hard as I probably did before. I'm just picking up this game to only have good fun, and that is really it. So I hope that I made my point clear. Look back to the race, skipping to the end of lap 10, opening up lap 11 right now, and we are definitely starting to slow down a little bit here. Maybe trying to feel the tire wear a little bit, but at the same time, the people in front of me, or the drivers in front of me, also slow down a little bit. Is it Rosberg leading? I think it is. But there's quite a bit of a battle for second place between one Mercedes, which is probably in Hamilton, and two Ferraris. They have been battling quite a bit. and luckily holding each other up a bit as well. So thanks to that, the gap to the guys ahead isn't as big as it probably would have been if they were all driving in clean air. The gap is in fact 2.3 seconds, which it pretty much was since the beginning of this race as well. Big oversteer moment there. That's quite good fun about the handling. He has to go very deep into this corner. Definitely losing some grip there and being way, way, way too wide there as well. Right, so this is the point where I start to feel the tire wear. The scheduled pit stop lap is about lap 14. 15. So I had a big cut there, that was very ugly. Apologies about that. Right. I think I might be pitting in this lap. I am starting to struggle with tire wear. The tire wear itself isn't too bad. If you look at the graphic, and I am like, what if I just go for a huge undercut? Which is exactly what I am going to do here. So we're coming to the pit lane. It means we are going to do 18 laps on the full wet tire here, which is a lot. But I felt like I had to do something different, because I was just stuck in that fifth place. Whatever I tried, I just couldn't do it. I tried to push hard, but it didn't work. So I'm switching to another set of wet tires. And it's very important for us that we end up in clean air. But look on the minimap, there are definitely a few cars passing the main straight right here. And so it doesn't really look like we will be in clean air. No, we won't be in clean air at all. We'll probably be joining behind Verstappen as Sainz is on my outside. There's no room for him there around the outside, obviously. So lap 12, and now is the time to push. Just came out of the pit lane, which means tires. It takes quite a while for the tires to grip up again after you exit the pits. But I had to do something different in order to maybe climb a few places. Another huge track extension there, very dirty. Skipping one lap further though, end of lap 13, and as you can see, I am catching up to Verstappen in front. In front of that, it's Perez, but look at the minimap, there are another two cars in front of that, so I need to get past these guys as soon as possible. Look on the grass there, on the braking, not great at all. Luckily managing to avoid Verstappen a bit there, not crashing to his rear. Coming through this section, and Verstappen going really slowly there. And I hit him on the back, at the back. And I drop another few seconds behind Verstappen yet again. And so this stint, the plan which I had, seems to be absolutely thrown into the bin by that accident. End of lap 14, more people in the pit lane. We see a car exiting the pit, which is Massa. And it does look like I lost a lot of time because of that, traffic and the whole spin Verstappen, who was really slowly on the apex there. I noticed it quite a bit with the AI sometimes. They are really slow sometimes on the apex of certain corners. And that's what happened. I just clipped the back and I was gone. It was a big shame to see Massa, who was behind me quite a bit before the pit stop phase. He almost rejoined in front of me. Obviously, he's falling back right now again because he has cold tires, and tires still need to get up to temperature, but it's not a great sign for us at all. And obviously we're gonna try to push. There's 14 more laps to go on this full wet tire. It's a lot, but I can actually tell you that it won't be 14 laps on these tires. I heard from my engineer that it is going to dry up in a little while, and that was just fantastic news for me, because if it wasn't going to dry up here, I was going to have to do 18 laps on a full set on a set of full wet tires, which is so much. And because of that incident I had with Verstappen, it wasn't going to work anymore. So luckily the weather gives me another chance. We see some more cars in the pit lane right here. Is Perez going to pit? No, he is not. I did expect it, to be honest. So we need to attack him, but again. Just slow on the apex, I hit him, probably my fault, but it's not ideal at all. And a few cars in the front already exited the pit lane, and looking at it, it seems like Ferraris. So that undercut strategy did not work at all with all the incidents I had, and Perez having decent strain on speed, struggling to get past at the moment. Still cannot get past as I... Oh, you see me there just you see me locking up quite a few times. I'm just not used to the brakes at all. I actually play this game slowly. I have to cut myself off because we're right on the back of Perez, who works rather late for this corner. So I can't do anything, but I have a better exit here. Better tires obviously around the outside of Perez here, off the outside line for the next turn. Braking late again, try to go for the undercut, which... another hit. Yeah, what can you say about that? I feel a bit guilty about that, because that's not the way I want to overtake, but... at the same time... I don't know. I really don't know. I'm just gonna leave it at that. I obviously hit him. The car behind is usually at fault, so probably the person to blame is me. But I don't know what kind of line that was from Perez, to be honest, either. Looks like he was going to stop in the middle of the corner there. Anyway, brought quite a bit of frustration, and you can see it with the driving now. Break quite late for the penultimate corner, just trying to push very, very hard. And about 13 more laps to go in the gap. The Sebastian Vettel in front is 6.2 seconds as we skip to the end of lap 17. And look at the minimap. They are pitting, it's going a bit deep into this corner, starting to lose grip. And I saw those guys pitting on the minimap, and I was like, I have to pit as well then. So intermediate tires here for me, most likely. I didn't select it, so I was a bit worried at this time that the crew was going to fit me again with wet tires. Let's have a look. It does look like the intermediates are ready, which they are indeed, so that's good for us. Intermediates ready for us. Get out up a little bit there. 4.2 second stop, joining behind Massa. But the next coming 11 laps or so, I can assure you, are going to be absolutely great. As there's a bit of a glitch here, I cannot shift up. Well, I could shift up, but for some reason it went down to second gear, which is quite annoying. Definitely not good for the engine either. We're out again. And as I said, I can assure you, the next coming 11 laps are going to be epic. I said in the beginning part of this video as well, I have done the first 3 races already. And those 3 races were all epic. I really think that they are epic. And I have been really lucky that those 3 races have been epic, because you guys are going to have, in my opinion, at least that's what I expect, a blast of a time watching the first 3 races at least, because they were so epic. Yes, my driving standards may have not been the best so far in this video, but these last laps, as I said, I can assure you they are going to be quite nice. These tires to grip up a bit. Obviously the track should be a bit quicker. Right. Engineer needs saying don't start thinking about slicks just yet, which I am definitely not thinking about. I am far from thinking about that. I'm not even sure whether we will reach the point where we can go to slicks before the end of the race. And even when it's lap 27 and the track starts to dry up, you're not gonna pit anymore, because it's just not worth it. Massa now obviously moves in front of us after the pit stop phase. We need to push very hard in order to close up to him. And I think I actually completely forgot to show my setup at the beginning of the race. That is my fault. If I can find it, I will paste it at the end of the video, so you guys can still see the setup. Sorry about that, I completely forgot, I just realized. But if I did record it, then I will put it at the end of the video here. Yeah. 10 more laps to go. Starting to close up to Massa, having definitely better pace than him. Well, obviously pushing quite hard as well. These tires are going to wear, but I don't care. 11 laps on the medium. Oh no, sorry, on the intermediate tire shouldn't be a problem. As I break again, late. But did I break too late, or did Massa break too early? Maybe both of them. Well, what is sure about it is that it's costing me time yet again. Very close to the exit of the wall there on the exit. End of lap 21 though. 4 tenths to Massa again, closing that gap down. Close behind him right now, picking up the slipstream. Can I have a dive on the inside for the next corner? I'm thinking about it, having a look. Not too far back. Look at the steering right now. So you can see that I'm just having a different driving style right now than I had before. I was really frustrated at this point in the race. I just wanted to perform well. and I felt like I could do so much better than I actually was doing. And so I go a bit too aggressive there, which is the wrong approach, because I lose a lot of time here for the main overtaking opportunity down the straight. So in fact was a bit stupid for me. P6 though, lap 22. There's another car in front of Massa, who is a backmarker, probably a Mander. Very close by Massa. This is our best opportunity. Yeah, pick up the slipstream in rich mixture down the inside for this turn. Just turn 3, breaking later than a bit of a lock up deep into the corner. But nothing Massa can do there anymore. So back up to P5, and now it's just the time to push like hell. Big oversteer moment there. But I feel like the oversteer moments in this game are very easy to correct. It's not like when you have oversteer, there's just no point you are going to catch the car anymore. Whether it's realistic or not, I don't know. I have never driven these cars. What I do know is that it's good fun. And that is, as I said in the video, what I'm really looking for. I'm looking for fun in this game. And this game, especially the handling, for me, gives a lot of fun. AI is better as well. It still has some weird things here and there sometimes, but their battling is definitely better. Racecraft, they still lack Racecraft, to be honest, quite a bit. So I'm going to dive on the inside of the back marker. But, well, it's definitely a step up from where it has been before. Coming to the end of lap 22, definitely not thinking about slicks just yet, and it's still raining quite hard, as you can see. Coming down the main straight here, trying to cool these tires a bit, trying to... don't give Massa slipstream. It's clear. Go deep into this corner as well. Just too inconsistent at the moment. And I can do a lot better than this. I know that. That is what, you know, frustrated me a bit. Nailing the curb there nicely, that was much better. As you can see, there is just quite a bit of understeer in that car. And I am pretty sure I was running high downforce as well. Skipping to the end of lap 23, Massa is behind, but he made a mistake since he fell back quite a bit. And look at the minimap, lap 23, and a lot of cars are in the pit lane. But are those the leading cars or are back markers? No, it are cars who were actually in front before, so they actually pitted. And DRS has been enabled yet, so apparently the track is dry enough for slicks. I can't imagine them going for another set of intermediate tires. Which first of all means we are up to P2. Secondly, DRS has been enabled. Thirdly, those guys behind are obviously on slicks, with Rosberg behind. But at the same time, is it dry enough for slicks? I was like, what the hell? Why is it time for slicks? I have plenty of grip here through that last corner we just went through. Plenty of grip there. I'm even cutting the corner over there. I just did not see a reason at all to go to the slicks. It's still raining. And it just looks way too wet for slicks at the moment, but hey, apparently it is dry enough, at least that's what the AI think. We'll be interested to see whether the AI is going to gain time on us. But what's interesting as well is that we are coming to the closing phase of the race. As I have another big cut there, apologies about that, very dirty for me. 30 second gap to Hamilton, so the victory is probably out of our hands for sure, or at least P1 at the moment, but 5 laps to go, is it worth to still pit? Obviously the longer you go now, the more you realize that pitting won't be right. Hamilton is in the pit lane as well, it's just unbelievable at the moment. I am like, how can you pit and go for slicks at the moment? It's still raining, there's a lot of spray coming from the tires, whatnot. And Hamilton was 30 seconds in front of me, and I thought I wouldn't catch up to him, but hey, we just overtook him. And is he going to stay in front of Rosberg? No. Oh, that wasn't Hamilton. That wasn't Hamilton. Was it? No. Okay, my fault. Sorry about that. That was not Hamilton. Skipping to the end of lap 25 though. Opening up lap 26 right now. And look at our mirrors. It's already Rosberg. Rosberg just 7 tenths behind us. I just couldn't believe that because it looks quite wet to me. But apparently it's dry enough for slicks. And so we are going to have, well, some amazing laps probably towards the end of the race here, because I am in P2 in my little Sauber. And I'm going to fight for it. I don't care that he is 3 seconds quicker at the moment. I will fight with it, with everything that I have got at the moment, in order to stay out of Rosberg. Obviously, it's not going to be easy. But hey, you know, I will try it. And still, look at this. Obviously, don't get me wrong, there's not that much grip for me than when I would be on slicks. Because, you know, that's clear. Rosberg gaining 3 seconds a lap. But just look at the turning and stuff, the grip looked relatively okay for me. And that's what I was saying. Now, I just didn't see a reason to change to the slick tires, with Rosberg now looking on the outside here for the next corner. It's going to take me with 3 laps to go. No, he doesn't. Nope. Oh, and he actually goes off the track. We saw that in the mirror. Rosberg going off the track there. And that is just fantastic for me, because that gives me a little breathing room again to Rosberg. Even you saw that, just I just slowed the car down too much for that corner. It is a little bit of a doubt for me now, every time I turn into a corner, how much grip there is going to be. Actually, these intermediates now are going to start to overheat. That's for sure. But again, I don't think it is worth pitting, as we see a few cars run into the pit lane. One of them is my teammate, who exits the pit lane right now. Hamilton as well, the cars were pitted, which means we are in first place with 3 more laps to go. But Hamilton behind, he will probably be about 3 seconds quicker a lap. And that's obviously a big difference. But I said it before, I'm going to fight with it, with everything for it, with everything I have got. That's for sure. Ericsson in front, our teammate, and look at that. Just, you know, I clipped the curb nicely. Yes, maybe there was a lift in the middle of the corner, but the grip is there. It's not like there's a lack of grip for me at the moment. I still feel comfortable. But as I said again though, slick tires, they are definitely the best option at the moment. But am I going to pit right now, you know? Answer is not. I'm not going to pit with 3 more laps to go in this race. Hamilton behind, his tires are yet to warm up a little bit, which gives me a bit more breathing room. His tires are probably warmed up by now quite a bit. Let's see what I can clean for here. A little bit of a track extension on the exit, but relatively clean. Definitely not the cleanest race for me ever so far, but you know, I hope you guys can understand that. And previously I used to be like, oh my god, I made a track extension, I'm really dirty and I'm a cunt and whatnot, but I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm just looking for a lot of fun here, which I'm definitely getting, and those little track extensions, they are there, I know, but I hope that you guys can deal with it. And I pretty much accepted it, that I am not the hardcore racer anymore in this game. Lap 28 though, not mine. This is the time where it's going to get real exciting. Watch the grip level here in this corner, watch this. Not great at all. Grip level obviously falling apart, tires starting to wear, obviously just less grip available for me overall on the track here because of the tires. And there's a car really close behind us, but it doesn't seem to be Hamilton. It indeed isn't Hamilton, it's a McLaren Honda, but Hamilton does have DRS on the McLaren Honda as we enter the first corner with one more lap to go in this race. Hamilton being really close behind us, and Hamilton actually gives us a tap from behind and sends us into the wall. Which means we dropped to P2, but that was really, really fucking dirty. I have no other way to describe it. And I was pretty pissed when it happened, to be honest, because that was a proper tap from behind. It wasn't like I moved over on him, I think, or anything like that. I think I stayed nicely to the inside of the track. And all of a sudden, shot a big bang from behind. I'm very lucky that I don't have any kind of damage. Ooh, not a big oversteer moment there. But yeah, I think that was pretty dirty from him, and I expected a penalty, to be honest, because that was just, you know, a proper crash, I think you could call it. There was no need for him to tap me over there, and it seems like we are going to lose the win because of that, unless Hamilton has got a penalty for that. Careful as well with Rosberg behind us, trying to cool the tires a little bit, they're going a bit offline. Look at the grip here, avoiding the apex right now as well. Take a few different lines to find where the grip is. Just a bit of sliding over here, this is all fun by the way. This is, yeah, a bit of sliding just to have some fun before the end of the race. Rosberg behind, but seems to be too far back. And so it does look like we'll pick up second place. As Lewis Hamilton is classified as the race winner. Despite that crash at the end, I'm still happy, because second place in my Sauber, I don't think that it is bad, but we definitely could have ended up in first place as well. Maybe the track conditions and the weather conditions were in our favor, you know, they definitely favored us. I was a bit lucky with that, and maybe Hamilton would have got me as well, you know, there was plenty of grip available for him, but I just felt pretty annoyed that, that he hit me from behind and I crashed. But still, second place, as I said, I'm happy with that as a Sauber driver.
That's the end of the first race here in Melbourne, and it's Lewis Hamilton who's got the upper hand and 25 points to his name.
Well, Lewis is always someone the other drivers respect. He's one of the best drivers on the grid, and if he has a competitive car, he'll always be near the front. And he's proven that yet again today.
After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Oh, very nice to be in second place then. I said it before. It was enjoyable for me this race, with the AI also being a bit more aggressive. But what's most enjoyable for me definitely is the handling. As I said, the perfect balance is just a lot of fun to drive, and it's just nice. That's all I think I really can say. I think that is pretty much it though. That was the first race. Next race will, I think, in my opinion, is going to be even better. So I hope you guys stay tuned for the next race. I hope you have enjoyed this first video of the career mode. Once again, I would like to apologize for the driving here and there. It hasn't been all the cleanest in terms of track limits, but also in terms of racing with the AI. But I'm still trying to get used to everything in this game, trying to see how the AI behaves when battling, and also, you know, the general handling of the cars. I'm just trying to get used to it, and I think I will progress throughout this season. So I think that's pretty much it. If you have enjoyed it, I would appreciate a like, and I really hope to see you in the next race, because that's going to be a fantastic one. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.